Hello everyone, myself A.S. Falmari, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to learn how to find out the roots of a complex number using de Moivre's theorem. Learning outcome, at the end of the session, students will be able to find the roots of a complex number using de Moivre's theorem. Let us start this lecture with a theorem. Let W is equal to R into the bracket cos theta plus I sin theta be any non-zero complex number. Now actually W is a complex number which is given in a polar form. Then the nth roots of a complex number W are given by Z is equal to the nth root of a complex number W is denoted by the notation W to the power 1 by n and is given by the formula R to the power 1 by n into the bracket cos of 2 k pi plus theta upon n plus I into sin of 2 k pi plus theta upon n, where k is equal to 0, 1, 2, so on up to n minus 1. Now working rule, now the step number 1, then the complex number whose nth root we have to find out. If that complex number is given in polar form, then we directly go for step 2. If that complex number is given in Cartesian form, then we have to perform this step number 1. This step number 1 is nothing but writing the given complex number in terms of a polar form. Suppose we have given a complex number in terms of Cartesian form like x plus iy, and we know that its polar form is given by x plus iy is equal to r into the bracket cos theta plus I sin theta, where two quantities we have to determine, r and theta, and that are given by r is equal to under root of x square plus y square and this theta is equal to tan inverse of y by x. And once we express the given complex number in terms of polar form, then we directly apply the theorem. Then by the above theorem, the nth root of a complex number is given by Z, that is equal to, now the nth root of the given complex number x plus iy is denoted by x plus iy to the power 1 by n, and it is given as r to the power 1 by n inside the bracket cos of 2 k pi plus theta upon n plus I sin of 2 k pi plus theta upon n, where k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, comma, so on up to n minus 1. Pause this video and write down the complex numbers 1, minus 1, I, minus I in polar form. I hope all of you have written the answer. Now we know that these are the standard complex number which has the standard polar form. Now, 1 has the polar form cos 0 plus I sin 0. Minus 1 has the polar form cos pi plus I sin pi. I has the polar form cos of pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2. And minus I has the polar form cos of pi by 2 minus I into sin of pi by 2. Consider the first example. Find the cube roots of unity. Solution. Now here, the provided complex number is unity. Unity means 1. Just we have discussed, a complex number 1 can be written in polar form as cos 0 plus I sin 0. Now here we have to find out the cube root of 1. By the above theorem, cube root of this unity is given by Z is equal to, now the cube root of unity is denoted by 1 to the power 1 by 3 and it is given as cos of 2 k pi plus, now original angle 0 divided by, here the value of n is 3 divided by 3 plus again I into sine of 2 k pi plus 0 upon 3. And now we know that 2 k pi plus 0 is 2 k pi, therefore we get Z as cos of 2 k pi by 3 plus I sine of 2 k pi by 3, where k equal to 0, 1, 2. Let us find out the values of Z for various values of k. For k is equal to 0, when we put k is equal to 0 here, we get a complex number and we denote it as Z0 is equal to cos of 0 plus I sin 0. we know that cos 0 has the value 1 and sin 0 is 0, therefore z 0 is becomes 1. Now next value of k is 1. Now putting k is equal to 1 in this formula, we get it as, and we denote this complex number by z1 is equal to cos of 2 pi by 3 plus I sin of 2 pi by 3 is equal to 2 pi by 3 is actually a standard angle. Now we can write it as cos of pi minus pi by 3 plus I sin of pi minus pi by 3. Now we know the results that cos of pi minus theta is minus cos theta and sin of pi minus theta is simply sin theta. Using these two results in this equation, we get it as minus cos of pi by 3 plus I sin of pi by 3, that is equal to, and we can write this minus as it is. We know that cos of pi by 3 is 1 by 2 plus I as it is, and sin of pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. Now this is the next required value of cube root of unity. And last one, for k equal to 2, we will denote the complex number by z2. Now putting k equal to 2 here, we get it as 2 into 2, 4. Now we get z2 is equal to cos of 4 pi by 3 plus I sin of 4 pi by 3. That is equal to, now we can write this angle 4 pi by 3 as cos of pi plus pi by 3 plus I into sin of pi plus pi by 3. Again, we know that the result cos of pi plus theta equal to minus cos theta and sin of pi plus theta is minus sin theta. Now, using these two results in this equation, we get cos of pi plus pi by 3 as minus cos of pi by 3 and plus I as it is, and sin of pi plus pi by 3 as minus of sin pi by 3 and this I as it is. And writing minus as it is, cos of pi by 3 is nothing but 1 by 2 minus I as it is, and sin of pi by 3 is root 3 by 2. Now these are the z0, z1, z2 are the required cube roots of unity. Let us consider one more example. If omega is a cube root of unity, then prove that 1 plus omega square is equal to 0. And also prove that 1 minus omega bracket raised to 6 is nothing but minus 27. Solution. Just we have calculated the cube roots of unity. I am not going to calculate again the same roots. We know that the three roots are z0, z1, z2, where z0 is 1 and z1 is minus 1 by 2 plus I into root 3 by 2. We will denote it as omega. And z2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2. We will denote it as omega square. Now adding these three numbers, we get 1 plus omega square is equal to, substituting these two values, we get 1 plus inside the bracket minus 1 by 2 plus I into root 3 by 2 plus inside the bracket minus 1 by 2 minus I into root 3 by 2. Now here we can see that this term is plus I root 3 by 2 and this one is minus I into root 3 by 2. They are the same terms with opposite sign. We can remove them. Now we can write this 1 as it is. Now here it is minus 1 by 2. Here is also minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is minus 1. And 1 minus 1 is nothing but 0. Now the next thing we have to calculate, or we have to show, that is 1 minus omega whole bracket raised to 6 is nothing but minus 27. Now the consider 1 minus omega bracket raised to 6 is equal to, now I can write here this power 6 as 1 minus omega bracket raised to 2 and whole bracket raised to 3. We have splitted it, that 6 as power 2 and power 3. Now expanding internal bracket, we get it as 1 minus 2 omega plus omega square, by using the property a minus b bracket square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now that is equal to, now just we have seen that the value of 1 plus omega square is 0. So the value of 1 plus omega square is nothing but minus omega. Substituting the value of 1 plus omega square as minus omega here and writing this minus 2 omega as it is and the bracket raised to 3. minus omega minus 2 omega is minus 3 omega and whole bracket raised to 3, and taking the cube of this one, minus 3 cube is minus 27 and omega cube is here omega cube. Hence it is proved. In general, the nth roots of unity has three standard properties. The first one is the sum of all the n nth roots of unity is always 0. That is, if 1 omega, omega square, so on up to omega to the power n minus 1 are the n nth roots of unity, then 1 plus omega square, so on up to plus omega to the power n minus 1 is always 0. One more important property is that the product of all the n nth roots of unity is always minus 1 to the power n minus 1. That is, if we choose 1 omega, omega square, so on up to omega raised to n minus 1 are the n nth roots of unity, then the value of the product 1 into omega square into so on up to into omega to the power n minus 1 is nothing but minus 1 to the power n minus 1. And the final last property is that all the nth roots of unity are always in geometric progression.